certainly the days of Martin Brodeur and Scott Stevens and Scott Niedermayer winning the Stanley Cup multiple times are over for the New Jersey Devils. It's been a tough go for them. One playoff appearance since getting to the Stanley Cup final in 2012. Let's bring in Mike Morial, who covers the Devils for us at NHL.com. Mike, though, this has been a constant rebuild here for a while, but it seems to be on track now. They got a lot of young players in the mix here. They beefed up in the offseason. Do you think the Devils are ready to take the next step? And I'm not saying the next step needs to be a playoff berth, but just to be really competitive and being in the mix in late March and early April.
I do, Dan. I think they needed to make some adjustments in certain areas of the ice, and they did just that. You know, they needed a right shot D, not necessarily right shot, but a defender with some name and some moxie, and Dougie Hamilton. I tell you, to get Dougie Hamilton, I think, Tom Fitzgerald did a great job there. The staff did a great job. They needed a backup goalie to get Jonathan Bernier. I thought it was a bonus for Mackenzie Blackwood. Blackwood played a lot of games last year, a lot of games on, you know, one day rest, after the what had happened with Corey Crawford when the Devils had signed him, and then he decided to retire a couple weeks later. But to get a bona fide goalie here that will challenge Mackenzie Blackwood for starts, I thought was certainly a bonus. And then to get, you know, secondary scoring, a player that they can put in the top six, and Thomas Tatar, I thought was great. You know, Tatar has been an elite goal scorer, in his years, the past few years with the teams he's played for. Obviously, he's a player that they'll look to maybe eat some minutes and play wing and do a good job there with either Nico Hischier or Jack Hughes. So I think the Devils did a real good job in this rebuild here, Dan, in getting players that really can, you know, maybe make an impact, a big time impact with the club this season.
Yeah, I think signing Dougie Hamilton was so big, not necessarily because Dougie is as good as he is. And I think Dougie Hamilton has to prove he's a number one defenseman. He's certainly getting paid like it. You know, in Carolina, there was Jacob Slavin and there was Brett Pesce. So they were insulating him. Now he is the number one guy. I know they have a few others there, and certainly PK Subban is still around with the New Jersey Devils. But I think signing Dougie Hamilton was big for them because, to me, it showed, and it shows the rest of the league, that big-time free agents are willing to go to New Jersey. And they believe in what Tom Fitzgerald, you know, is building there. And I think that's a huge play for the Devils right now to showcase that to the rest of the league, because they are. Look, I mean, the names, Jack Hughes, Nico Hischier, Jesper Bratt, Igor Sharangovich, Yanni Kuokkanen, Pavel Zacha, you know, Mikey McLeod, Alexander Holtz, Ty Smith, Blackwood. All these guys are 24 or younger, and they're good, yeah. Mike. They're good players.
Yeah. Yeah, I totally agree. You know, look, Hamilton was the big fish, right, on the free agent market, and the fact that Devils were able to get him and what they were able to do, bring him in and then sign him, I thought was a true feather in their cap. But look, Hamilton's a right shot D. As we said, he's one of the best power play defensemen in the league right now. New Jersey just so happened to be one of the weakest teams on the man advantage last season. So, the Devils needed some boost on that power play. You know, Hamilton had scored over 100 power play points and over 600 regular season games. And last season, he led Carolina in ice time per game with the man advantage. So that and his ability to produce, Dan, on offense from the back end will be a boon for the team. He's strong at even strength, something Coach Lindy Ruff is very vigilant about. They need to produce offense at 5-on-5. And then finally, Hamilton can eat minutes, you know, thanks to his smarts and his offensive skills, you know, make him one of the most valuable blue liners in the NHL from an analytics perspective. He's 28 and still has a number of good years in him.
Yeah, no question. They also got Ryan Graves. So, I mean, that was a big one too. So for their D, and I think they're better. Like you mentioned, Tatar certainly adds to their scoring up front, but this again, and well, I want to touch on the goaltending, but before I get there, to me, the thing to watch this season for the New Jersey Devils, the biggest thing to watch, is the continued growth and development of their top two centers in Jack Hughes and Nico Hischier. And these two guys elevating their games to prove to everyone around the league that the Devils have one of the best 1-2 combos down the middle in the league. They will eventually have that. They still have something to prove, but this is a big year for both of these players. Nico's got to stay healthy and Jack Hughes has to continue to elevate his game.
That's one of the things we always talk about, right, Dan, when we get together at Prudential Center to watch a Devils game. It's the progression of Nico Hischier. It's the progression of Jack Hughes. You know, Hischier being named captain last February. Huge. Unfortunately, he had some injuries, some COVID concerns. You know, Hughes had a career year, showed vast improvement in his adjustment to the NHL speed and the physicality of the game. He's always been courageous in getting to the tough spots on the ice, but to do it at an NHL level was quite a chore in his rookie season. He was able to get to those areas, you know, last season, used his speed and creativity, had a career year with the numbers he put up. Now he needs to take it to another level in year three. And I think Nico Hischier, knowing the value of being a leader, what it takes to be a leader in that locker room, and just his presence on the ice and his two-way acumen is really going to benefit the Devils long time into the future.
Yeah, no question about it. All right, quickly on the goaltending, because you touched on it with Bernier before. I think Mackenzie Blackwood, I think he could be the number three goalie for Team Canada. I think he's that good. At the Olympics. I like Blackwood's game. I think there's a lot of growth in his game, but you need another goaltender to help you, because in the NHL, you can't be riding your guy 60 to 65 to 70 games anymore. Those days are over. If Blackwood plays in 50 plus games, you're going to get almost 30 or more from Jonathan Bernier. He's got to give you points, and that is where it helps, because Jonathan Bernier is a goaltender who is good enough to get the Devils some points. Whereas in years past now with Blackwood, I just don't see that he's had anybody else there.
Couldn't agree with you more, Dan. You know, Bernier is going to help alleviate the workload on Mackenzie Blackwood. Blackwood missed six games in January because of COVID. Played 21 of his 35 games on one day of rest or fewer. We all know what happened last season when he was forced to play that many games and what transpired with Blackwood. He still had a decent season, but it was difficult. Bernier has a 2.77 goals against, over a 900 save percentage, 18 shutouts in his career with five different teams. So he has the experience. He'll keep Blackwood honest. He doesn't have the size of modern netminders. Goes about 6 foot, 184 pounds. Mm-hmm. He relies on that butterfly style, that technique and reflexes, but he'll be a steadying presence in the crease and will lighten the load for Blackwood. No doubt about it, Dan.
So I don't think they're a playoff team yet, though. I think they're improved. I think this season's a growth season, a big time growth season for them, but I can't put them in. What about you?
Yeah, the Devils needed to improve several areas. We talked about them to keep up with the likes of the Islanders, the Penguins, Caps, Rangers, Hurricanes. I think they certainly did that. And they'll be competitive, but I don't think everything is going to come together overnight. There needs to be growing pains. Patience will be needed. New Jersey needs to be in the fight first, Dan. They need to experience a late season playoff drive. I think they'll be in the mix and they'll experience that pressure, you know, and then when under duress, they'll be able to get the necessary scoring, keep the puck out of their net, and maybe have success on the power play when it matters most. I still think the club is a year away. I'm with you, from becoming that type of serious contender to qualify for the postseason. But I think a lot of pieces are in place here. It's just a matter of coming together, learning how to win with these players and this coaching staff.
He's Mike Morial. He knows the Devils. He knows so much else. So follow his work all season at NHL.com. Thanks, Mike.
Thanks, Dan.